So welcome to Yoga with Smiles from Vrindavan Yoga and Smile Makers Training. So today I'm going to start a new series of talks, Smile Tips. And these tips are from a book that I've been reading since last 30 years. I read it very often. It is Sai Satcharita. And I would like to take small snippets from there and share them with you because they have made a huge impact on my life. So I thought I would share something from there. Okay. So in the very first chapter, he talks about a woman who, you know, in yoga, we have one chalana asana where we go round and round like this. You know, in the olden days, they used to have these wheels where they would grind the wheat by putting it in between two stones and they would turn it round and round. So this woman was watching that and she told her guru that I feel so overwhelmed with life. I feel as if I'm crushed in this worldly existence. What do I do? Now we have so many moments when we just, everything gets a bit too much for us and we feel so overwhelmed with everything. So the guru gave a very nice answer. He says that the lower stone of the grinding wheel represents karma. I don't have to explain karma. Everybody knows karma. As you sow, so you reap. But basically, if I can put it in three words, I will use the words of tamas, rajas and sattva. I don't know whether you all know this, but tamas includes all the attributes that, to put it mildly, make us lazy, you know, make us feel depressed, make us feel lethargic, make us feel postponing, and everything associated with those kind of attributes, that will be called as tamas. Opposite of that is rajas. Rajas is overdoing everything. You know, getting overexcited, getting angry, getting irritated, getting violent. And all the attributes which contribute towards that is called rajas. And between the two, when both are balanced, you know, we have this sattva, that is where peace and harmony and purity and all that. So in our worldly existence, we are exposed to all these three attributes. Sometimes tamas, sometimes rajas, sometimes sattva. And he says, the guru told her, is that the downstairs is karma, but we need to go higher up. And the up wheel which is there is bhakti or devotion. When I say devotion, I mean devotion to some higher power. Whether you call it Sai Baba, or whether you call it God, or whether you call it universal consciousness, or you call anything. Okay? It's the faith in that higher power. The faith in that there's someone up there who is taking care of us. Okay, that will be the above wheel, the top wheel. So you have, both these things need to go together, your karma and your bhakti. Okay, and what happens is that when both are together, you, the grace of your, you know, it will help you to grind all your sins and ego and all these attributes, whatever is associated with that, we will be able to grind it. That faith in the higher power. But she says, what do I do? She says, you hold on to the handle of the wheel. Because when you have the higher power, you will go up and go towards the handle. And the handle is the handle of knowledge. The handle is a handle of self-realization. So what basically the message of this story is that most of the time we are always going outwards and trying to find answers outside of ourselves. Okay, but what Guru has said by this is that you need to go inwards. Okay, and this, go to this handle of self-realization, go to this handle of knowledge, and keep spending time inwards, because that is where you will get all your answers, along with devotion. So a simple, very nice explanation of karma, bhakti and dhyana, that is self-realization. Okay, So this is just an introduction to tell you, like when we do soft skills, what am I doing? Most of the time, whenever I give you these small smile tips, what am I doing is that I'm just telling you, start looking at yourself. Start improve your self-awareness. Be aware. I'm not saying what I'm saying is right or what is wrong. But you're just saying is that just be aware that there is always a different way to do things. Okay? So self-awareness is a starting point of self-realization. Yeah? So just a small tip, and I thought it was such a beautiful analogy of the grinding wheel. So instead of being feeling crushed by the worldly existence, you just hold on, go inwards along with the higher power, you know, go in the path of self-realization, and then you are sure to be saved. Okay, so that's it for today. Have a wonderful, wonderful yoga session next. Thank you.